So in this video, we are going to explore MetaHuman. So I got access to MetaHuman Creator, and a few people have gotten access to this. So I'm really excited for this. So let's check this out. Okay, so we are in MetaHuman Creator and this is totally running in my browser. So this is kind of streaming all those polygons and everything. So it is basically live streaming the data of polygons and everything. So it is not using my computer's resources. It is running on a cloud computer. Okay, so first we need to pick a character on which we will build our character. So this is going to be the base template of our character. So you can choose whichever character you like. Once you have selected your character, you can press that next button. So the UI and everything looks pretty good. So in the bottom of your screen, you will have all of these modes. And currently it's in the preview mode, so you can preview your animations. Let me go to the sculpt mode. And in the sculpt mode, you can sculpt your character. So as you can see, you have all of these points. And you can select each point and you can move it. So for example, you can select this point and just move your mouse. And you can modify the geometry of the face. After that, you can change the lighting. So you can change it to indoor lighting and outdoor lighting. So you have all of these lighting preview options. After that, you can also change the camera. So there are a lot of camera views here. So you can change these cameras. By default, it's set to auto. But again, if you want to focus on a certain region, you can do that. Okay, so now let's dive into the character creation of MetaHuman. So let's take a look at the blend option. So under the face, we have this blend option. And this blend option allows you to select three faces. So just click and drag these faces. And you can basically blend between these faces. So once you have these three faces selected, you can click one of the dots and essentially you can blend between these faces. And you can do this for all the regions of the face. After that, we have the skin, so we can change the color of the skin. After that, you have freckles, so you can change the design and you can change the strength and everything. After that, you have accents. And accents is really cool, like you can select a certain region of your face and then you can change the saturation, lightness and everything of that region. So that's pretty cool. After that, we have eyes. So we have a lot of eye presets here. So you can click on each preset and you can preview it on your character. So this real-time workflow is quite powerful. So these are some advanced options for your eyes. Next, we have teeth, and I really find this quite funny. So we can change how our teeth looks essentially. So this is also quite easy. Like, it is not a technical application. Like, you don't require any technical knowledge for this. Just move these sliders and you can see the results real time on your character. So this is quite powerful. After the teeth, we have the option to apply makeup. So we have some eye presets right here. So you can choose whichever preset you like. You can also change the color of the makeup. So everything is completely customizable here. After the eyes, we have lips, so you can also change the color of the lips and everything. So here you can define your hairstyles. You have different kinds of hairstyles here. Again, click on the hairstyle that you want to add and it will appear and apply in real time. Next, we have eyebrow presets. So you can change how your eyebrow looks, you can also change the color of these eyebrows. After that, you have some eyelash presets. After that, we have some facial hair, and again, we are not going to apply that. After that, we have body types. So we have the short, the average, and the tall. Okay, after the body, we have some tops. So as you can see, the clothing options are really quite limited. And they're going to add more clothing options and more accessories and stuff. But for now, clothing is not a main thing. This will be mainly used for creating realistic human faces. Okay, so as you can see, we have created our character. And this looks quite realistic. So MetaHuman is really quite powerful. This is how easy it is to create something this realistic. So once you exit out of that, you will see your MetaHuman in my MetaHuman section, in this section. And if you want, you can further edit this. So that's it guys, and I hope that you like this video. So if you did, please leave a like down below, it really helps. Also, thank you for all the people who supported on Patreon. So yeah, that's it. I'm gonna see you in the next video.